Hello friends and welcome back. In this lecture, we will talk about the public, private, and static keywords in Java. Now, these keywords are used in object-oriented programming. But in this lecture, I just want to give you an idea, alright? So, we are going to talk about the public keyword, the private keyword, and the static keyword. So, let's see the public keyword. First of all, it is an access modifier. This means that it can specify how to access classes, methods, and fields. So for example, you already know that we can use the dot operator in order to access fields and methods of classes and objects, right? So we can change this functionality by using access modifiers. And public is an access modifier. So if we use the public keyword, this means that the access level is everywhere. So everything that is public can be accessed inside the class, outside the class, inside the package, and outside the package, all right? Now let's talk about the private access modifier. This is also an access modifier, and if we use private, this means that the access level is only inside the class. Everything that is private cannot be accessed from outside the class, all right? Now let's have a look at the static keyword. It is a non-access modifier. Whenever we use the static keyword, we will be able to access fields and methods using the class name. So for example, we already know that we can type system.out. So we are accessing the out field using the name of the system class, right? So this means that out is a static field of system. So if it is not a static field, we will not be able to access it using the name of the class. So now let's go to our IDE and see everything in action. This is the same project from before. I am in the main.java class and the main method is empty. Also inside this class, the main method and the sayHi method are also empty. So let's start by talking about the public keyword. So sayHi is a public method. This means that it can be accessed inside the class and outside the class. And in the previous video, we called the sayHi method inside this class, right? And this is because it is public, so we can access it from other classes, okay? Now let's go back over here and let's make the sayHi a private method. So put private keyword instead of public. And now let's try to access the sayHi method in this class over here. So I will use the name of the class, and now I will use the dot operator. Have a look. We cannot see the sayHi method over here, and this is because it is private. So we will not be able to access it from over here. But anyway, let's type sayHi like this. And we have an error. The error says sayHi has a private access in our class. So as I said, we will not be able to access it inside this class over here. All right? Perfect. Let's go back and let's put this back to be public. So in the main class, the error is gone and now we can access the sayHi method. Okay, I'm going to remove this code and let's go back to this class. I will make this method private again. And now I'm going to use it inside this main method. So I'm going to call sayHi. And as you can see, we have no errors. So we can call the sayHi method inside this class. So when we use the private access modifier, we can access the method or the field only inside the class. Okay? Now let's talk about the static keyword. As we said, static allows us to call the method using the class name. So for example, over here, I'm going to type the class name and I'm going to use the dot operator. So first of all, because we are inside this class, we can see the sayHi method over here, even if it is a private method, all right? And also, whenever we use the dot operator, we can see sayHi in the list over here, right? And this is because it is a static method. So for example, I'm going to remove the static keyword. Let's use the dot operator again. Now we don't see the sayHi method. And even if it is a public method like this, also we cannot access it. So have a look and we still can't see it, all right? So to be able to access something using the class name, we will use the static keyword. Now let me show you this. I will remove this code and I'm going to call the sayHi method in here, all right? And as you can see, we have an error. Look at this. Non-static method sayHi cannot be referenced from a static context. So what does this mean? As you know, the main method is a static method and it must be a static method, right? So if we want to use a method like this inside the main method, this method should be static. So let's add the static keyword over here and now the error is gone. So let me give you a small summary. The public keyword allows us to access the methods and fields inside and outside the class. But the private keyword only allows us to access them inside the same class. And the static keyword allows us to access the methods and fields using the class name. And if we want to call a method inside the main method directly like this, this method should be a static method. So this is a general idea, and later on we will talk in much more details about these keywords. So great job. This is it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.